Trust your first impression. What are you sensing? Is it daytime or nighttime? Use all of your senses. What's the first thing that pops into your mind? Remember, you're not seeing with your eyes. You're sensing. Where are you?
Everything's still black.
Everything is black. Very good. That's fine. Sometimes when we arrive in a place, it could be dark. It could be inside a place. Maybe you just need to turn the lights on. I want you to just feel your way around it. I'm sure there are days that you've maybe experienced this yourself, where you go into a room and it's dark and you sense that there's people in there, and they may pop out of the couch and say, "Surprise, because it's your birthday." But you knew there were people there because you sensed it. You have different senses that you use. So as you are in this dark place, using your mind, I want you to sense what it would feel like to be in this place. You can kind of tell if you're indoors or outdoors. So use always the first impression, whatever is the first thought that you feel. So what does this place feel like? Would it be indoors or outdoors? Don't judge it, don't analyze it. What's the first thing that pops into your mind?
Maybe in.
Okay. So as we turn our attention to what it would feel like to be in something. It could be in anything. So this inside a place in the dark. Trust your impression again. Does it feel like it would be a big place? Or a small place?
Nothing is really clear.
That's okay. That's okay. The whole thing is to trust whatever feels right. Remember, you're daydreaming. So in this place that's indoors or outdoors, what would you imagine it to be like? What are you getting? What are you feeling? What emotions are coming up? Because there's very strong emotions coming up. What emotions are you feeling?
Like then I had like the brief image, like I was looking down like a cliff and then that went away.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I don't know.
Perfect.
I don't know if I am inside.
That's perfect. You're doing great. Always tell me the first thing that pops in.
Okay,
I can't tell what you're saying. So if sometimes images will just pop up one after another. So as they pop up, we can just catch them. So if you see this cliff, let's go back to this cliff. You can reimagine it again. Allow yourself to reimagine that image that you just saw of that cliff. What does it look like?
Very steep. There's like a river at the bottom.
What's at the bottom?
Like a river.
A river. Very good. So where are you standing on the cliff? Are you looking at it or are you on the cliff?
I'm like at the top. Looking down.
So let's see what else is around this place. Expand your imagination and see what's around.
Yeah, it's like a desert.
Like a desert. Very good. How does it feel? Does it feel hot? Does it feel cold?
Like dry.
Dry.
Yeah.
Tell me what else you experience in this place. Use your imagination. Expand it out like a rubber band.
Yeah. Almost, it's like in the middle of nowhere.
Mm-hmm. Middle of nowhere. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Do you feel like you're high up in this place?
I feel like I'm grounded.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Can you tell if you have a body in this place or you're just floating around? How does it feel? You can look down and imagine what it would be like to have a body if you do.
I think I have a body.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to imagine just a spiritual mirror in front of you, just as if you had a mirror pop up and you can see yourself in that life. What do you look like?
I feel like I might be a guy.
Mm-hmm. You're a guy. How are you dressed?
When I went to look at my feet, it felt like cowboy boots, maybe.
Cowboy boots?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
You don't have to try hard.
Yeah.
It's like when you look in the mirror. Allow yourself to peruse the mirror and see what it looks like.
I feel like you're just like a Western cowboy.
A Western cowboy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I have long hair or if it's... I feel like it's long hair.
Mm-hmm. Are you wearing anything on your head?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. What are you wearing?
Like a cowboy hat.
Mm-hmm. I want you now to take a look at your hands. The mirror has disappeared now because you now can see yourself. Mm-hmm. Look down at your hands and see if you're carrying anything.
I just look at my hands and they seem like they're dirty and
mm-hmm.
rough.
Mm-hmm. Are you there by yourself or is there anybody with you?
I feel like I'm there by myself.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what it is that you're doing there. I want you to just center yourself into that place. Just like as if you were on a holiday and can just look around you and peruse what's going on. Allow yourself to relax into that place and have the images pop up. Let's see what's there and why you're there.
Like a horse, a brown horse.
Mm-hmm, a brown horse.
Yeah.
Very good.
Like brown hair, like a mane.
That is
it. Makes me happy.
Makes you happy. Very good. Is this your companion?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. Can you get a name for that horse? What pops into your mind? What's the first thing that pops in?
Halo.
Halo. Mm-hmm. Very good. When I say the name Halo, do you seem to get a reaction from the horse?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's find out what you're doing there. Take me through this scene. Tell me everything that happens. What are you doing there?
I felt like I was just walking along and just I saw the cliff and I looked down and just had thoughts of that it's just really far down.
Mm-hmm. Did you have any type of other thoughts on that cliff? What other emotions did you get from it? Did you have curiosity or fear? What other emotions are you?
I'm like shaking.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Maybe it's really long. It's a long ways down there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't know if I need to go down there.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you need to go down there to get to where you're going?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's advance that scene to where you're going, where you're going.
At the water.
Mm-hmm. You're at the water. You're at the river there?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's happening there at the water?
I was putting the water in my hands and, you know, like, looking at myself, like, splashing myself.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel?
Good.
Mm-hmm. What else happens there?
I'm still by myself. I'm with my horse.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like a smaller river.
Mm-hmm. Is the river, is the river deep, or is it like a stream?
Maybe more like a stream.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure what we're doing.
Mm-hmm. It's fine. Do you feel that you know where you are, or are you just exploring?
Maybe just exploring.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So keep going and let's see where it takes you. What emotions are you feeling with this?
Like I'm just out. I don't know if I feel like I have a mission or something. Like I feel like there's something I'm going towards.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not sure what that is.
Okay. So I want you to imagine the scene closing behind you. Just close the scene and open it again to where it is that you're going. Where you're supposed to be.
I see a town.
Mm-hmm.
Dirt roads. Like buildings on both sides.
Mm-hmm.
Has like the wood little porches and things.
Yes. Is there anybody around?
I feel like, yeah, just random people.
Mm-hmm. How are these people dressed?
Like, the women are wearing dresses.
Mm-hmm.
Men are dressed like me and maybe a little nicer.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel in this town?
Not like it's home.
Mm-hmm.
But then I'm just like passing through maybe.
Okay. So let's see what significant event happens in this place.
Just keep thinking like bank. I don't know why I keep thinking bank.
Okay, let's find out. Continue. What happens next?
Walk into a building. There's a guy at a counter.
Mm-hmm.
Not really sure what's like prior to that when I kept seeing bank, I felt like I was hanging on to like a big like satchel of money or something.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know why.
It's okay. So what happens in this bank? What happens next?
I feel like there's somebody else sitting in the bank. Like, I don't know if it's like a security guard or something.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Someone to like stand there to look tough to try to scare people.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel when you see this man?
Kind of annoyed.
Mm-hmm. Why do you feel annoyed? I want you to...
Like he's just... Like, ugh, like, why does he have to be here?
Like, mm-hmm. Let's find out why you feel that way. Take me through the scene. What happens next? Where do you go?
I feel like it, like, kind of, I don't know if it, like, ruined my plan or I don't know.
All
it
right,
seems so weird.
Let's continue.
I feel like nothing like big happened.
Mm-hmm. But what thoughts are you thinking about? What was supposed to happen? trust your first impression. What were you going to do in that bank?
I don't think I was there to rob it. Because I feel like in my heart, like, I'm not that type of person. I feel like I'm a good person. I don't think I was there to rob the bank, but I don't know why I'm annoyed. Like, it was just like this grangly looking guy in the corner with like a gun just sitting there, like, you know, like just trying to put on a tough face, or I don't. So I don't know if I'm doing like business with the bank, maybe.
So let's find out. Let's find out. Just take a deep breath in and allow all of the events to unfold. Let's find out what happens in this bank. Allow yourself to go deeper. Each breath takes you deeper. And the images will just clear up for you.
We're like sliding things underneath, like a... almost like a glass window, you know, and then underneath it has like a cutout, so you just slide things.
What are you sliding in there?
Feels like money.
Tell me what happens next. Where is this money from? Is this your money?
It doesn't feel like my money.
Do you feel this money came from somewhere else?
Yeah.
So what are you doing with this money?
Like delivering it?
Let's find out who you're delivering it to. Who's getting this money?
I don't know if it was more of like I delivered the money to the bank.
Yes. Was this a job?
It feels that way.
This job that you're doing, do you feel that it's something that's honorable?
Yeah. So I feel like people rely on me and I'm reliable.
So is your job to deliver money to the bank?
Seems like it.
Okay. Very good. Is there anything else in this scene that's significant to you?
Just that guy bothered me. I don't know if I felt like he was just not a good way to do that. Doesn't look very professional just to have, I don't know.
Okay. What emotions brought up, did you feel when you saw this man?
Like he might may not be doing it for the best intentions. Like he doesn't seem maybe all that honorable.
Yes. Okay. Very good. Let's close that scene now. Let's move forward in that same lifetime to another significant event. Something important is happening in your life. Go drifting and floating to that event. And tell me where you are.
Isn't that like a table? Where are you? I'm eating. I'm sitting at the head of a table.
Where are you located? Is this a home?
That's yeah.
So tell me what's there. Look around you. Who's at the table with you?
I see a lady.
Who else is there?
Maybe a small, like a small little boy.
Look down and see what you're eating.
Some type of meat. Maybe some potatoes.
What's significant about this event? How do you feel about it? What's happening here?
Doesn't feel happy.
Mm-hmm. Tell me how it feels.
I don't know if I'm assuming the lady there is like my wife, and that she's worried.
Mm-hmm. I want you to connect with her telepathically, from mind to mind. See what's concerning her.
My job.
Mm-hmm. What kind of job do you have?
You're like a transporter.
Mm-hmm. What's her concern?
I'm out there alone.
Mm-hmm.
And that I might not come back.
How do you feel about your job?
I feel like it fulfills like the being honorable.
Mm-hmm.
Being reliable, that's important to me.
Mm-hmm. What is it that you transport?
Feels like just various things. It feels like it's for an important person, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
Company.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Do you have a name for this company? What name comes to mind?
Like Peterson?
Mm-hmm. Peterson?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Good. Let's close that scene now. Let's go to another important scene when something important is happening. Allow yourself to drift to that scene. Look around you.
My horse is on its side.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
I feel like it either died or it... I think it died.
Where are you?
I'm out in the middle of nowhere. I don't see anything. I just like... It's a lot of desert with a few, you know, big rock mounds and where you can see like the layers in the rock.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell if the horse died instantly or was it sick? What happened to the horse? Connect with the horse.
Like it was sick. Because
mm-hmm.
I wasn't riding it. It was like I could see it and it was just laying on its side with its legs out. And now I'm feeling like, oh, crap.
Mm-hmm. You're on your own now.
I'm in the middle of nowhere.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens. What do you do now?
Just try to gather as much as I can. And just start walking. I feel like I'm by that cliff again.
Mm-hmm. walk me through this whole scene. Mm. What happened? What do you do?
It just sounds so weird. Like, I feel like there... I'm just gonna say it. It's like a UFO, like came out of nowhere. Like,
what is it?
A UFO.
Mm-hmm. You see a UFO?
Yeah.
Okay. Tell me what it looks like.
It's gray, mm-hmm. circular.
Mm-hmm.
It's like three little blue lights in the center and the bottom.
Mm-hmm. And what happens?
Like I'm like beamed up.
Mm-hmm. And what happens next?
I'm just kind of laying there.
Look around you and tell me what it looks like there.
Like, I feel like I'm in the center and it just feels like there's like a room there and then a room over here. Like you can walk into different mm-hmm. little rooms.
Does it feel large or small?
Small.
Mm-hmm. Are you lying down or sitting
yeah,
down?
Yeah, it's like I'm like it's like you're beamed up and it's just like I'm just I haven't had a chance to like actually sit up.
Mm-hmm. So take a moment to adjust your surroundings. Look all around you. Just describe everything.
It's bright and just kind of gray. Like I said, I can kind of just see like these two like possible rooms.
Mm-hmm. What do you imagine these rooms are for?
I feel like they're just searching.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing.
Do you feel like you're alone, or are there others there with you?
I feel like there might be two others.
Mm-hmm.
Like a little gray.
Mm-hmm. So allow yourself to be in that moment when you see who's there with you.
For some reason, I'm not scared.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost, it's like they, it's always like you again, or, you know,
mm-hmm.
like I've been here before, maybe.
Mm-hmm. I want you to allow yourself to connect telepathically with these beings, mind to mind. You're familiar with them.
They say hey.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Like, oh, you know, it looks like you're kind of in a situation.
Mm-hmm.
Like they're kind of here to help me.
Mm-hmm. What else do you get from them?
It's just so, like, I'm just, it's so weird that I'm not scared of them.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you know them?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out more about them. Let's find out what they're there to do.
They're here to keep an eye out on me.
Mm-hmm. What do you have to do with them?
Like, maybe, yeah.
Connect with them. Use your mind from mind to mind. And let's see what they're telling you. listen to their words, listen to their thoughts, and tell me what they're saying.
I'm here to do a job. Mm-hmm. That they were just kind of, they picked me up because I think they felt like I may have been kind of screwed.
So they're giving you a lift?
Yeah.
Find out what the mission is.
I just keep seeing the word Earth.
Earth, Let's find out more. What's your mission on Earth as a transporter? What did they say?
I need to connect more with them.
You need to connect more with them? Are they asking you to connect more with them?
It's just the feeling that I get.
Let's find out more. What did they tell you about the Earth?
They're not saying a whole lot.
I want you to advance that scene now. Yeah. Let's advance the scene where you're getting more information.
My arms are like numb right now. I feel like I don't really feel them anymore.
All right. So let's close that scene. Close that scene, and now let's move to another significant day in that same lifetime. Move forward. You're older now. And something is happening. Where are you?
I feel like I'm laying down.
How old do you feel?
Like 60s?
What's happening?
Maybe breathing.
I
hear the words.
What words do you hear?
Like that's my breathing.
What happens?
It's just hard to breathe.
So I want you now to move to the moment where you're taking your last breath. And as you do, I want you to think about your life. Think about your life there. And tell me, what is it that you're thinking of when you're in the process of transitioning?
I thought I was just very passionate and like very proud of the jobs that I did. And I don't know if my family, it didn't feel like my family came first. It felt more like a duty to do my job.
Okay.
Came first.
Very good. All right. So go ahead and take your last breath. Transition out of that body and tell me where you go.
Floating up. To the clouds. Bright light.
And then what happens?
I kind of just go into the light. There's, it's like, it's like a pop right up. It's like an oval, like a half moon like table.
A half moon table.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Maybe like five or six. Feels like many people sitting there.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
It's hot. I don't really see faces. Mm-hmm. You can just tell that there's people there.
Do they feel like male or female energy?
Maybe mix, maybe more male. Mm-hmm. It's like more male dominant. Mm-hmm.
So as you arrive at that table, what happens?
They ask me, like, the purpose.
Mm-hmm. And what is the purpose?
It's just hard to... I felt like kind of like the lesson was that I spent more time and energy and cared more about my job rather than the feelings of my family.
Mm-hmm. So how did that affect you? What karma did you get into from that?
That I need to feel what it maybe feels like to not be put first, like, mm-hmm. in a way. Mm-hmm. Like, if I was my wife, I would be just annoyed, mm-hmm. frustrated. I think that's what I got from that.
Very good. So let's see what happens now after you meet with your counsel. What do they tell you?
On to the next.
So let's find out what it is that you need to do in your next life. What do you need to learn? What's the mission and purpose of it?
Like what it feels like to be the wife. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So let's go to the moment where you're picking your life and the people in it. Who's with you to help you?
There's the lady.
Mm-hmm. Who is this lady?
Somebody that, like a mentor. Mm-hmm. Somebody who's just kind of guiding me.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out how she's guiding you. What are the things that you're discussing?
What I need to experience. Mm-hmm. What'll be good for me.
So what are the things that you're talking about? What kind of experiences?
Just what it feel like to be maybe on the other side of that life, mm-hmm. like what the wife went through. Mm-hmm.
Are there any people that you are picking to be in that same lifetime?
I see the word Tony.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. So let's find out who Tony is in the life before your life.
I just keep seeing wife.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. I want you to see yourself making an agreement with Tony. You tell me what happened. What are you picking up from it?
I just feel like we shook hands.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
And that we're gonna do this together.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's close that scene now. Close that scene. And now we're going to go drifting and floating to another time, another lifetime, where there's information that will help you in the very best way. See yourself drifting and floating through time and space. And allow the scene to open to find out where some of this information is hidden.
I just, I see like a little baby.
Mm-hmm. I see a little baby.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me more.
It's like in a, like a woven basket.
Mm-hmm.
And some sheets. Just a happy little baby.
Mm-hmm. Where is this baby? Look around. Is it indoors, outdoors? Where is it?
It's like we're indoors, but it feels like a treehouse, kind of. Like, mm-hmm. You know, more everything's
mm-hmm.
wooden because it's just in a little circular woven little basket.
Mm-hmm. Tell mm-hmm. me more.
It just makes me happy.
Is this your baby?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So take a look at yourself and tell me what you look like.
A woman.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I feel like I'm dressed in like native clothing.
Mm-hmm.
I have dark, long hair.
Mm-hmm. The
baby looks, it just looks like, it feels like it's my baby, but it feels more like it looks so white.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so I don't know what that's about.
Let's find out, does this baby have a father? What are you feeling? What's the first impression that you get as to who the father of this baby is? What's the first thing that comes into your mind?
I feel like he should have a father.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like it's just us.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm almost beginning to wonder if I didn't necessarily have the baby.
Mm-hmm.
But I still consider it to be my baby. I don't know, like I adopted it or something.
Mm-hmm. So let's close that scene and let's find out whose baby this really is. Where it came from. And who the parents are. Go drifting back, and you'll know the answers. What do you see?
I see like a big, maybe like a big ship.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Like a big ramp. Mm-hmm. And coming from the ship onto yes. the land.
Yes.
I don't know if...
Allow the scene to just play out. Just allow it to play out. Who's on the ship?
I see people... You know, big dresses and fancier clothing. I see like a lady holding on to a baby. Mm-hmm. I don't know why. I don't understand why they're here.
Mm-hmm. What feelings are you getting from them? What emotions do you feel when you're looking at these people? Go deep inside. What emotion comes to mind?
I don't know if they thought they were somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that they're where they want to be.
Mm-hmm. Do they look lost?
Not at first. But I feel like they're in like my village.
Mm-hmm.
And we didn't expect them to be here.
Mm-hmm.
So how the does ship that make- is like a big metal ship, so I'm just really confused. Yes,
mm-hmm. It's a metal ship. Very good. That's mm-hmm. fine. Don't use any judgment. Mm-hmm. What does this metal ship look like?
Reminds me of like the Titanic, kind
mm-hmm.
of. Like big like that.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I went onto the ship.
Mm-hmm.
Like I went up that ramp. Like, kind of sneakishly.
Mm-hmm. So you snuck up the ramp?
That's how it feels.
Mm-hmm. Where did you go?
Kind of looking in the windows. There's just lots of, like, fancy cloth, like, red. Like, the seats are all... Everything looks fancy.
Mm-hmm.
Curtains are fancy. Just looking in the windows. And I see that lady again with the baby.
Does she see you?
I feel like not at first. But yeah.
Mm-hmm.
She's not scared. She's more of like loving.
Mm-hmm.
Like hi. You know, mm-hmm. and she's not scared of me.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think surprises me. I'm just drawn to her baby.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think she likes that.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like I reach out and she like kind of like swats.
Mm-hmm.
Swats me away. And now she doesn't know my intention.
Mm-hmm. What is your intention?
Like, I just want to hold on to the baby.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to cause any harm. I just want to hang on to him. And she doesn't like that.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like we can't speak the same, like, language.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to hang on to our baby. I don't know what's... I feel like There's a guy now. He's kind of yelling at me. I feel like I should leave. He's yelling. So I just try to get off the boat. I run back down the ramp. Go back into like the jungle. So now I'm sad. I don't know why I'm so obsessed with the baby.
Let's go to the scene where you finally get the baby. Let's find out what happened. Where are you?
I'm back on the boat. I must have snuck back on the boat. I find where the baby is. And I take him. And I sneak out. And I go back. And that's kind of where I have him in a basket. And he's happy. Which makes me happy.
So now let's close that scene and let's move forward in time, in that same lifetime, to see what happens. What's the next significant event?
I see fire. Lots of fire, like chaos, hanging out to the baby. I feel like it might have something to do with me. I'm just running. I feel like I'm on the beach, just running away, holding onto the baby. Have him wrapped up. Trying to get away.
What happens?
I feel like I'm stopped.
Who stops you?
Men, like three men. I don't know. They're not letting me go by. It's not like they're native men.
How are they dressed?
It's like they have, metal on them. So I don't know if they have a sword or if they have guns, but they, they are blocking my way and I can't get through.
Do they have armor on them?
Yeah. And I don't really know if, they know if this is my baby or if it...
So what do they do?
They're making me go with them. I have to walk with them. I'm still hanging on to the baby.
Is the baby in your arms or in the basket?
In my arms, like wrapped up. Going with them. I come back on the boat. And I come in front of that woman again. And they hand over, like, the hand over the baby and they ask the woman if this is her baby. And she says, yeah. And I know that I did something wrong. And I know that I might have to be punished.
How does that make you feel?
Like, I shouldn't have done that. Mm-hmm. But the baby just made me so happy.
Mm-hmm. So let's fast forward now. I want you to close that scene. Fast forward to see what happened to you.
It's hard because I feel like I'm back at that cliff. I'm just like keep being like right on the edge of that cliff again, so I don't know what.
How are you dressed there?
I'm the woman.
So let's see what happens now. What happens on that cliff?
I feel like I'm alone. It's almost like I can't live with what I did. So it's more of like a suicide, maybe? Like,
let's see what happens.
I feel like I jump. Like, face forward. Just fall.
So now, as you transition out of that body, I want to know what happens next. Where do you go? Do you go anywhere?
I feel like I'm still at the bottom of that cliff. Not moving. At the bottom of the cliff. Alone.
So move forward in that same lifetime to see what happens to your soul, to see where you go. Where do you go?
I see a man. Splashing his face. With a horse.
And what do you do?
He doesn't see me. I just go up to him. Attach myself, but I stay with him.
So now that you have attached to the man in that lifetime, why have you continued being attached to the lifetime of Katie?
I'm getting sad.
Tell me why you're attached to Katie now. Why did you follow that life all the way here?
It's the babies.
It's the babies. Tell me about that. You knew she would be working with babies, didn't you? You were going to take advantage of her, didn't you? Knowing that she was going to be working with babies and you'd be able to be with them. Where is it that you're attached to her? What part of the body?
Like my throat.
I saw you when you appeared there. What is your name in that lifetime? What did they call you? What's your name?
Alaya.
Alaya. Alaya. Why is it that you wanted a baby so much?
I feel like I lost mine.
How did you lose your baby, Alaya?
Like disease.
A disease?
Yeah.
So now, what are you planning to do, Alaya? Your baby's gone. Would you want to be with your baby again?
Yeah.
Was it a boy? Or a girl? Would you like to be with your baby?
Yeah.
No. But you can't have your baby by being attached to this woman. You're just living your life through her, and it's not your life, is it? No. Would you like me to help you, Alaya? Alaya, I'm going to call in my angels of the white light and have them surround you. And I want you to feel their love. Tell me when they're there, Alaya. How do they feel to you?
Love.
Alaya, inside of your heart, there's a spark of light. I want you to look for that light. Can you see it? Expand that light out until it takes over your entire essence, your entire non-physical body. And tell me how that feels when you expand it. Does that feel like the love that you're looking for in a baby? Would you like to feel more of that love? All right. So the only way we can do that, Alaya, is to detach yourself and go back home. Now tell me, what have you caused this woman by being attached to her? What symptoms has she felt?
Like sadness.
Sadness. Have you given her any physical symptoms? What is that?
Not being able to catch her breath.
Not able to catch her breath. What else?
Some of the anxiety.
Anxiety. What is that anxiety coming from, Alaya?
Just not having my baby. Getting caught with the other baby.
Yes. Do you have anything to do with her thyroid? Not functioning properly.
Yeah, I think so.
Were you attached to her thyroid? Why did you attach that?
It was easy.
Why is that?
It was weak.
Has that thyroid always been weak?
Yeah.
Alaya, did you attach to her as a soul? Did she come with that?
I feel like, yeah.
So you followed her from that lifetime as that man all the way into this one. Do you have anything to say to Katie about your actions?
I'm sorry.
deep breath in, Katie. What would you like to tell Aliyah?
It's okay.
You ready to let her go? Okay. Aliyah, I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And when I do, I want you to give me all of those feelings that you've been feeling all of this time. Go deep inside. All of the anxiety of not having your baby. Of not being able to be a mother. Of wanting to always be around babies. So you can fulfill your role as a mother. Give it all to me. Because once you go back home, Aliyah, you'll be able to be with your baby once again. Can you feel that? Bring it all out. Tell me when I have it all. All that shame of having done that. Alright, I'm going to take that out and give it to the universe. Now, Aliyah, on the way home, I want you to feel completely at peace and joyful. What would you like to put in its place?
Love.
Let's put lots of love. Feel that fire hose of love going in there. Feeling all of that brilliant white light and love going through all of your essence. Fill it up. And I'm going to touch your forehead so we can seal that in. Is there anything else you would like to fill it with?
Happiness.
Lots of happiness. Let's put all that happiness in there. What else?
Joy.
Mm-hmm. Lots of joy. Fill it all up with joy. Very good. Are you ready to release now? Alright, I want you to go inside of this woman's body and pull out all of your essence. And Katie, I want you to go inside and tell me what it looks like.
Just little ropes.
Little ropes, okay. I want you to go in there and start cutting up all those little ropes, pulling them out from the roots and cutting them, detaching them from all of your area of your neck, in your chest, any area where you feel that Aliyah has connected with you. Tell me when you've taken all of those ropes and cut them. Alright, Aliyah, I want you to pull those ropes out, take them with you, and I'm going to ask Archangel Michael to take you by the hand, and the angels of light accompany you. Go up to the crown of her head and go directly to the light. And tell me if there's anybody there to greet you.
Yeah.
Who's there?
I see a man holding a baby.
Mm-hmm. Is this your baby? Mm-hmm. Very good. Aliyah, thank you very much for being here today. May the light of the universe accompany you always. Thank you. I know that you could have shown Katie many different lifetimes today. Why did you show her the one about that man riding the horse who was taken up by a spaceship? Why that life?
She needed to feel what it felt like to have a job that was honorable. To feel reliable.
Has she had many lifetimes?
Yes.
Why in particular did you show her the one with the UFO?
I think she's curious in that aspect. If there's a connection there. If she's had other lives outside of Earth.
Yes.
I think it was just a little glimpse of just...
Yes.
Like, yeah.
Is she one of them?
I believe. Maybe at one point.
Has she been contacted in this lifetime? She seems to live in an area that may be easy for that.
I hear not yet.
Not yet. Oh, okay. Will there be in the future any connection?
Yeah.
Okay. What's going on with her ear? She says she feels it fluttering like someone's blowing in her ear. Who is that?
It came to mind. I hear Grandma.
Grandma? Mm-hmm. Which one?
Grandma Lucy comes to first.
Mm-hmm. So what is Grandma Lucy wanting to tell her?
That she's loved and she's being watched over.
Mm-hmm. Did Grandma Lucy have anything to do with the accident? Protecting her? Or was that somebody else? What happened that day when she had an accident mm-hmm. and was protected by that blanket?
I feel like it was more than just Grandma.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if can you there's an angel.
Can you take her back to that moment? Take her back to that moment. I'm going to touch her forehead. And I want you to see that moment again in slow motion. And see you going into that accident. Tell me what happened. Who was there with you?
I see a big set of wings.
Mm-hmm.
Big, bright wings.
Who is that?
I hear like Archangel Michael.
Mm-hmm.
Just big wings.
Big wings. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So what did Michael do to protect Katie from this accident?
Kind of encapsulated.
Mm-hmm.
Encapsulated her. Until the car stopped.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So mm-hmm. now she knows.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Michael, for that beautiful gesture.
Mm-hmm.
And she had a question about her birthmarks.
Mm-hmm.
She has two birthmarks. Where are they coming from?
She's known this, but mm-hmm. she was shot.
Mm-hmm. She was shot.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Is this a psychic that told her that?
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
How does she know that she was shot?
Once she learned that birthmarks
mm-hmm.
can mean kind of like baggage, I guess, mm-hmm. from past lives.
Yes.
She... It kind of remembered
mm-hmm.
in a way.
Does she have anything attached to that life that she needs to disconnect from? Is there a reason why she brought those birthmarks in there?
I hear yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you take her to that life to show her what's going on? Tell me where you are.
Like I'm a gangster
mm-hmm.
kind of that okay. life.
Mm-hmm. Well, tell me what you look like.
I have black hair. It's slicked back
mm-hmm.
to the side. I'm male.
Mm-hmm. Look around you and see.
I'm surrounded by a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Just piles of money.
Mm-hmm. Where does this money come from?
Your drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
I see Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm maybe like a newbie
mm-hmm.
kind of in this role.
Young?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what happens. What are you doing there? What's your role?
I feel like maybe I'm just kind of learning. Learning from the others.
Mm-hmm.
Getting used to being around that much money and having it not bother me.
Mm-hmm.
What are they? And drugs too.
And drugs.
Yeah.
Are you taking any of these drugs?
No. Mm-mm.
What do they call you in this life?
Like, I feel like my name might be like Charlie, but they call me like Char, like for short, maybe.
Mm-hmm. So when I say the name Char, does that resonate with you?
Yeah, kind
okay.
of.
Like, so Char, how old are you there?
You're 18.
Mm-hmm. So take me through and let's find out what happens to you.
I'm in a vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in the back seat. There's two male driving. They're discussing what the plan is for this next job.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm supposed to just be listening. Let me stop. Let me get out and just like kinda like a dock.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm kind of standing behind these two males, and they approach two other people, and they're discussing and I'm just kind of listening, and the other two people kind of ask who I am, like, who's this guy?
Mm-hmm.
You know? I don't really speak for myself at that point. The other two are saying, you know, he's with us and he's just a new guy that we're, you know, showing the ropes.
Mm-hmm. And
the other two male, they accept that answer and continue on business. We walk with them kind of down the port. Maybe walk into a building. Kind of a tall, big, tall ceilings and tables. Lights that are hanging very high from the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
There's other people. They look serious. And I think they're going to discuss like a big shipment, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
That's worth a lot of money, so it's very important. And I'm just kind of learning and listening. There's really nothing more. It's just, I think they accept a deal.
Mm-hmm.
And they say that they'll be in touch. And then we're brought back to our vehicle. And we get back in our vehicle. And the people in front, they kind of asked me if I, you know, how that was, because I felt like that was maybe like my first time
mm-hmm.
being involved with another group of people.
Mm-hmm.
Another group of like gangsters, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Was this a new group?
It like more or less like just being working with other the people, other departments, I guess, through
mm-hmm.
this
mm-hmm.
gangster life. I don't know. And I tell them I feel like I learned to be serious and to show no fear.
Mm-hmm.
I worry though, because I feel like I might not be cut out for it. I feel like I might be too weak.
Yeah.
To do this type of work. I feel like it's maybe time for me to go out on my own now.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I've had enough training.
Mm-hmm.
There's somebody else with me, kind of like my partner. He has a little bit more experience, but not much.
Mm-hmm. So now let's go to the time right before you die.
It's just a deal gone totally wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I feel like I didn't do anything necessarily wrong. I feel like maybe the other people took advantage. They could maybe sense my weakness.
Mm-hmm.
And they took advantage of that, so they shot me.
All right.
So they could take.
All right, so Char, I want you to see yourself there before you transition, being shot. Tell me what happened.
I fall to the ground.
Mm-hmm. What are you feeling?
Kind of like, I knew this wasn't, I knew I wasn't going to be good at this.
Mm-hmm. This wasn't cut out for you?
Mm-hmm.
All right. What thoughts are going through your head?
I should have known better, but yet I felt like I wanted to try to be a gangster. Like I wanted to see if I could be that tough.
Mm-hmm. And now that you're there?
And now I realize it just isn't.
Okay.
Obviously wasn't for me.
So Char, before you leave in that lifetime, I'm going to put my hand on your chest so that we can help heal that. I want you to give to me all of those feelings of not being able to accomplish what you wanted to accomplish in your life. Turning to a life that took all your life away very young. Of that betrayal, of that being shot so young. Not being able to reach your potential. Give it all to me. Do I have it all? I'll take that. And Char, what would you like me to put there instead?
Courage.
Mm-hmm. Let's put lots of courage in there. Feel that courage coming in. Feel it coming in. And just seal that. What else?
Just strength.
Mm-hmm. Lots of strength. Mm-hmm. Feel it coming in. Physical, mental, emotional. Spiritual strength. What else would you like to feel?
Fulfillment.
Mm-hmm. Let's pull that in. Knowing that you, the 18 years that you did live, or the time that you lived, was lived fully, the best of your ability.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Anything else to feel complete today?
Mm-mm.
All right. So Char, as you now transition, you don't need to be connected anymore to any other lifetimes. Knowing that you can go back home, back to the light, totally free in light. May the light of the universe accompany you always, Char. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let me speak with the higher self again. She had a question about her anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
Where did it come from? And she even had mentioned that it seems to sit on her neck. Was that a lie?
Partially.
Mm-hmm. What's the rest of it?
I don't know if there's something else there,
mm-hmm.
maybe.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel totally gone.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me where? Just do a little scan of that area and tell me where it's sitting.
Like,
mm-hmm. Right. I thought so. All right, so I'm going to bring my hand up, 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 up. Good afternoon. How long have you been there with Katie?
Like 5 years.
5 years. How did you find her?
She was sad.
She was sad. Mm-hmm. Were you sad too when you found her?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you male or female energy?
Male.
Male. Mm-hmm. What may I call you?
Alan.
Alan? Mm-hmm. Alan, how old are you?
35.
Mm-hmm. And where did you live when you had a body? Do you recall the last time you had a body?
No, it's hard.
Mm-hmm. Have you been without a body for a long time?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Alan, I want you to think back. Just take a deep breath and go back in time to see how it is that you died in your last lifetime.
I feel like I was stabbed.
You were stabbed. Where did they stab you, Helen?
Right here.
Yeah, in your chest. Who stabbed you, Helen?
Brother.
Your brother stabbed you. Did you have a fight or was it a betrayal? What was it all about? Was it an accident?
I think it was just the heat of the moment.
Mm-hmm. So what happened to you after you died? Your body died. Where'd you go?
Stayed in that room.
Mm-hmm.
And as time went on, I kind of ventured out.
Mm-hmm. So how did you find Katie? Where was she?
She was in her dorm.
In her dorm?
Mm-hmm.
Why were you stalking dorms? Is there a lot of sadness there?
Lots of emotions.
Mm-hmm.
Easy emotions.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Because people weren't in their safe environments, so they were more vulnerable.
Mm. And that's a good place for ones like you to attach?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How could she have avoided an attachment?
Protecting herself.
Like with what?
With white light.
Mm-hmm.
That would have scared me away.
Ah, okay. So, Alan, what are you getting from her?
I can thrive off of her worries.
Mm-hmm. What does that do to you? Does that feed you?
Mm-hmm.
What does it feed you?
Just makes me feel stronger.
Mm, okay. So her fears and worries make you stronger.
Mm.
Mm. Alan, I could think of a better way to make you stronger. Would you like to know about it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alan,
We all came from the same place. We all came from that spark of light, that white light that you're so afraid of. Do you know that you have that white light inside of you?
Yeah.
Take a look at it and expand it. Feel it getting bigger and bigger, and tell me how that feels.
It feels good.
Mm-hmm. Can you remember who you are now, Alan?
Yeah.
How do you feel?
Good.
Good. Alan, I'm going to call my angels of the light to come surround you so that you can feel their love.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Alan, do you want to be forgiven for what you've done to Katie? Tell her about it.
I'm sorry if caused you so much anxiety and pain. It wasn't nice.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't your anxiety, or your pain, or your worries.
Mm-hmm. Take a deep breath in. Katie, what do you want to tell Alan? You ready to let it go?
It's okay.
Mm-hmm. Alan, I want you to go inside of her and pull all of that out. All of the attachment that you have to her. Katie, let me know what it looks like from inside.
It's kind of black.
Mm-hmm. I want you to use whatever tool you need to use to get rid of that black. It could be a vacuum, it could be a hose. What would you like to use?
A vacuum.
All right, so go ahead and use that vacuum. And Alan, while she's going on the inside, I want you to pull from the outside. I want you both to work on that area and clean it all up. And I want you to give all of that blackness to the angels. Give it all to them. I don't want you to leave anything inside, no anxiety, no worries. We don't need that. And tell me when you're done. Are you ready to go now, Alan? Very good. I'm going to have Archangel Michael take you by the hand and go ahead and go up to the crown of her head. And tell me when you get to the light and tell me if there's anybody there to greet you.
It's so bright.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel now?
Very good.
Good. May the light of the universe accompany you, Alan. And let me speak with our higher self now. How does that area look now?
It's clean.
Very good. I'd like to ask the higher self and the angels to come in now and flood her body with that healing light. Don't leave any area untouched. Fill her with light. Encapsulate all of those areas that were harmed before and just fill them, heal them. And let me know if there are any other entities that are messing with her today. Or is she clean? Take a look at her body. Anywhere else?
If there is anything.
Mm-hmm.
In her head, I just feel like it's like cloudy.
All right, let's find out what that cloudiness is. Bring it down. Bring it down. Tell me what it is that's in there. Who are you?
Black.
Black. Is that your name? Black? Mm-hmm. Black. Are you male or female?
Male.
Male. Why are you in her head?
It's easy.
How long have you been there, Black?
For a while.
Mm-hmm. How did you find Katie?
She was so vulnerable.
When was this? How old was she?
Keep getting mixed.
Mixed what?
Maybe when she was really young.
Mm-hmm. When she was young.
What do you do to her?
Influence her thoughts.
You influence her thought. What kind of thoughts do you give her?
Negative thoughts.
Negative thoughts. Okay. Do you influence her to maybe be around people that are not beneficial to her?
More of the body image.
Mm-hmm.
That you can't do it.
Mm-hmm.
You're not good enough.
Mm-hmm. Why do you give her these thoughts, Black?
Is that how you feel?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What happened to you? How did you lose your body?
Can you remember?
Maybe I don't know if I drowned.
Mm-hmm.
I just see water and mm-hmm. going down and down. It gets very black.
Mm-hmm. Is that why you call yourself Black? Because you're down at the bottom of the ocean?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. So Black, let's get you out of that. I want the angels to surround you and fill you with light. Allow that light to be filled. And as that happens, tell me what happens to you, Black.
It's getting lighter.
Mm-hmm. How about you? How are you feeling? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I want you to come up to the surface now. Feel your soul coming out of that blackness up to the surface. And when you get there, take a deep breath in. See yourself surfacing. And tell me what happens.
I can see myself.
Mm-hmm. What do you look like?
Like a young male.
Mm-hmm.
Not super like attractive, I guess, like
mm-hmm.
kind of a receding hairline.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's where I was being told.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Did you go into that water voluntarily? Or did someone put you in there? What happened? How did you get into that water?
I see a sailboat.
Mm-hmm.
Storm.
Mm-hmm.
I think I was just knocked off the boat.
Okay. So what is your name? What do they call you?
I keep seeing the word curious, but that just,
mm-hmm.
I don't know how that can be a name.
Mm-hmm. If I call you curious, does that sound like your name?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So curious, now that you know how you lost your body, are you ready to go to the light?
Go back home? Because you were lost for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So retrieve all of that fogginess from her head, from when you were hit. And you're thrown over, hit on the water. Remove all of that fogginess. And Katie, I want you to go in there and use whatever tool you need to clear up all of that fogginess, what would you like to use now?
Like a vacuum.
Let's use that vacuum, suck all that up. I want that brain to be totally clear of fogginess. And when you're done, give it to the angels that they're waiting for it. Curious, are you ready to go home now? Pull everything out by the roots. And do you forgive yourself for being part of her life? Mm-hmm. Katie, do you forgive him?
Yeah.
Thank you. Go ahead. Go through the crown of her head, and Archangel Michael's going to accompany you to the light. May the light of the universe always be with you, Curious. Thank you so much.
Let me speak with her higher self. How are we looking now?
Better. She's just vibrating so much.
That happens. This struggle that she has with her weight, did it have anything to do with this last entity that we were talking with?
Maybe more of just like the body image.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell her about that?
That when people tell you that you're beautiful, you believe it.
Mm-hmm. What about the discomfort that she has in her tummy? What's going on with that?
I don't know if something is there. Mm-hmm. She was just having a pain on her left side.
On her left side. Would you allow me to talk to this? Let's take that up, bring it up, 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 up. Good afternoon.
Hello.
Are you male or female?
Male.
Male. How long have you been there?
A long time.
Why are you there?
Cause some pain.
Mm-hmm. And why is that? Are you in pain?
I was in pain.
What kind of pain were you in?
Just stabby pain.
Stabbing pain. Did someone stab you?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. What's your name, by the way?
Colby.
Colby. Mm-hmm. Colby, are you ready to go to the light?
Mm-hmm.
I want you to take all of the attachment that you have inside of her. And Katie, you know what to do. Go inside there. Tell me what it looks like. All right, take that vacuum and start disconnecting all of that. Colby, I want you to take all of that attachment from out of her. Pull it all out. Colby, start filling yourself with white light. I'm having the angels surround you. Fill yourself with white light. Feel the comfort and the love of that white light. Tell me what you're feeling, Colby.
I'm feeling hot.
You're feeling hot. Good. Is that a good?
Yeah, it's a nice warm.
Mm-hmm. Fill yourself with that white light as you pull all of that influence from inside of her. Pull it all out. I don't want you leaving anything inside. Colby, did you come on your own accord or did someone send you?
On my own.
On your own. Are you ready to go back home, Colby? All right, pull all of that out.
I'm asking the angels to surround you. Archangel Michael, take him by the hand. And Colby, go up through the crown. Pull everything out. Don't leave anything in. Pull it out. All the way out, all the way out. Don't leave anything. And tell me when you get to the light, Colby. How are you feeling?
Okay.
You made a lot of the universe accompany you. Colby, is there anything left where you were?
Mm-mm.
Very good.
Let me have the angels go in there and clean up everything that needs to be cleaned up. Go through her whole body. Fill her with light. Surround her with that white light. Check her aura. Seal any places in her aura that may have leaks. We don't want to have anything going in or out.
Mm-hmm.
Check all of her chakras. Align them, please. And while you're doing that, if the higher self can continue doing a body scan to see if there's anything else that we need to address today.
No.
Very good. Before you go, I'd like for you to connect with her puppy, Bella. And tell me what's going on with Bella. Why is she so scared of riding in cars?
She hates the vibrations and the noise and the small space.
Mm-hmm. What can we do to help Bella?
Help instill in her that it's going to be okay, that she won't be harmed.
Mm-hmm. Has she been harmed before?
Not by us.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We adopted her, so.
Yeah. Can we connect with Bella today and give her that information?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Can I ask the higher self to please relay that information to her?
Mm-hmm.
That's safe. Is there anything that the family can tell her before they put her in a car to remind her?
You are loved. You are safe.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. She's also asking about her best friends. Can you tell her if they have had lives together?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I just see like this triangle, circle.
Mm-hmm. They've been there together again before.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
We help each other with different things through different lives.
Mm-hmm. So they're meant to be here together.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Very good. Is there something that I didn't ask that I could have asked that you would like to tell her about today?
Meditation. Mm-hmm. She struggles with finding
mm-hmm.
like a place or just to meditate to help raise her vibrations.
Yes.
She's still learning how to do that.
Can you help her with that?
Yeah.
Thank you. Anything else you would like to tell her? Maybe the guides that are working with her.
I just hear she is loved.
She is loved.
Mm-hmm. And she is guided. Just trust. Mm-hmm. Trust in her guides and trust in the path that they sent her on.
Mm-hmm. Don't question it.
Mm-hmm.
Very good.
And have faith.
Wonderful. Wonderful. So if you would do a scan of this room and see if there's any other entities that need to be taken care of today.
I like can sense somebody standing.
Mm-hmm.
Standing like at the foot.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like to ask the angels of the white light to go ahead and quickly throw a net over this being. Mm-hmm. Throw a net over them. Encapsulate them. And let's find out why this being is here and take them where you need to take them. Right to the light.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Any others around that shouldn't be here?
I don't think so.
Very good.
And I don't know, her left thumb is like on fire.
Mm-hmm. What's going on with her
left thumb? I cannot move it.
That's good. It'll be able to move in a moment.
Okay.
Very good. So are we complete today? Are we complete? Or do you have any other final messages for anybody?
Just continue what you're doing.
Wonderful. Wonderful. I'd like to thank the higher self for all the information it's given Katie today.
Mm-hmm.
She's really going to appreciate it. Thank you very much. Wide awake. Wide awake.
Oh, wow.
How do you feel?
My hands.
Mm.
They were like heavy and like vibrating.
And now, how do they feel?
Still.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about this experience now that you've lived through it?
Oh, it's almost like a reminder that I feel like I've connected on these levels before,
mm-hmm.
and it's just like a reminder that I can, like I, whatever I'm feeling, that
it's real.
That it's real.
Yeah.
I feel like it was confirmation of that, which is nice, because I don't know, it just confirms for me that maybe I have been able to connect.
Yes,
before.
Of course you have.
Yeah.
What about these lives? Wow.
Well, yeah, I don't know, the whole cowboy thing, and then like...
That was interesting.
It was just like a UFO, and I was like, oh, great. Like, in my head, I was like, ugh, here we go. Like, like, I don't know, it's almost like I've...
But you felt very comfortable.
Yeah, and it wasn't...
Was it scary?
No, it wasn't scary.
Like, hey, mm-mm. How you doing?
Yeah.
I've been here before.
Mm-hmm.
You're in a weird situation. Let's get you out of that situation.
Yeah, it's almost like, okay.
They saved
like,
you.
You need to, you know, you're kind of in a...
In a bind.
Yeah.
No horse.
We'll help you out, but...
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
And then the woman, that was interesting, huh?
Yeah. Because that didn't feel like...
No, she attached
like
it
was,
to
that's
him.
Why I was questioning, like, why would I steal a baby? Like,
mm-hmm.
like I wouldn't do
And that. When you see this video, you're going to be really surprised, because both of those entities showed themselves.
Through the way I was moving?
No.
Oh.
You will notice in the video that you had a really red splotch right here, and you had a really big splotch on top of your chest.
Am I red right now?
No.
When I get nervous, I get red.
No, that's who
so
they were.
That's interesting.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
When she says, oh, I'm in the neck, I was like, oh, yes, you were. You were right there. And then the other one was stabbed, and it was right there.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see it in the video.
God.
That the splotches come out. Yeah.
Weird. Because that my entire life, like, yes, mm-hmm. I get, like, mm-hmm. just nervous situation, or, like, you know, just... I get red and splotchy, so interesting. So
yeah, very interesting. Now, you know, I had witnessed that before, but not as bright as that. That just came out like saying, here I am.
Yeah, yeah.
It was really interesting, right? So now that we've had this experience, the question, do you want to share this?
I think so. I think, like you said, just maybe weed out some of the... And there wasn't anything...
I don't think there was anything really personal in there.
Mm-mm. Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Excellent, excellent. So let's sit up and we're going to say goodbye.
My arms are like I'm shaking, but it's like because I'm vibrating. Like
that's happened to me before.
Like I'm like when I got into the maybe with that the second lady, like my body was just like
I'm going to give you some shungite to hold now so that you can relax with that. Yeah. That'll help you a little bit.
Like, I even felt like my eyes were like...
Yeah. Let me turn the light on. So
okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
So now you've had the experience. Mm-hmm. And now what would you like to tell everybody about this experience?
I would just do it. Just try it.
Like, it's not a Nike commercial.
Well, I feel like so many people are, I don't know, maybe hesitant, or if you are hesitant, yeah, like, just do whatever you can to do it, no matter if people give you grief about it. Like,
you've been
getting. Yeah, like I've been getting. It's like, no. Like, well, tell
everybody what kind of grief you were getting. Because you were trying to share this information.
Yeah, I guess maybe just people not believing in this, I guess, and in past lives in general. Sometimes people just don't believe that. But I just really felt like, I don't know, it just feels so real and it grounds me. I don't know.
And how did these lives look? Were they clear to you? At the beginning, you were like...
At the beginning, it was so hard,
right?
Because things just kind of would come and then they go away. But then once I just believed or, like, let it happen, yeah, and, like,
yeah,
not questioned it, then it, like, yeah, with the gangster. Yeah. I had slick back hair, and I was kind of, like, pudgy in the face. But I'm, like, yeah, that was so weird. Oh, my, I forgot about that one.
Yeah. But even the lady who was stealing the baby.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember feeling, like, hunched over, like, oh, I'm going up the ramp, like, ugh.
So it seems to me that when the cowboy went to the cliff,
mm-hmm,
that was the spot where this woman had killed herself.
Yeah.
So it seems like he may have picked up, because he was in a bind.
Yeah.
That was her moment where she attached
mm-hmm
to them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I'm like, why am I at this cliff? Why am I at the cliff again?
And it seems to me that when he was at that cliff and he was feeling like something.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the moment where
mm-hmm
it became a, or he when he was down at the water or something.
Yeah.
Because that's where she had died.
Yeah, because it was like, oh, I'm at the, with her, it was like, oh, I'm at the top of the cliff looking down at that river. And then it was like, boom, I'm at the river, and I could see him, like, when I first said I was, like, washing my face or looking at in the water, I was watching him, like, splash his face with the water.
So that's
when I could see his horse.
Like, so that's when he attached.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, weird.
We just put the puzzle pieces together. That's so cool, isn't it? It all works out when you really start doing this. So how far did you come from for this trip?
I came from Wisconsin.
Go Packers.
Hopefully they win today.
So what would you like to tell our folks out there that, like you,
our
viewers?
I mean, just give it a shot. I mean, I'm down here on a vacation, but I tried to sneak it in, so.
I did.
So, just give it a shot. It's totally worth it. You have nothing to lose. If anything, you have a lot to gain.
Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm, it was great.
Yeah.
So if you would like a session with me, just like Katie had, mm-hmm, you can go to my website, albaweinman.com, and I do travel around the country. I will be traveling all over the place. You can sign up to my mailing list. You see where I'm going to next. So until the next time.
Yeah.
Bye. Bye. Okay. Best part. The hug.
Oh, thank you. You're probably feeling shaking.
Oh, you're so shaking. Let me give you the shun guy, okay? And, this is what I'm going to give you
to hold
while we're doing the recordings. This is shungite. Ground you.
Oh, okay.
How's it feel?
Good.
Good.